This is Grace Notes. I'm Alan Button, and our guest today is Dawn Turner. Dawn is a former longtime elementary school teacher, youth pastor at Church on the Rise, in fact, two-time Teacher of the Year in the Edgecombe and Nash Rocky Mount school systems, and currently serves as International Students Services Coordinator at North Carolina Wesleyan College. Dawn, welcome.
Thank you. I'm so honored to be here.
Well, it's great to have you here. I have heard some good things about you, to understate the matter, and want to hear some of the details. Could you start by telling us a little bit about your personal history?
Yes, sir. I'd be happy to. I was born and raised in Rocky Mount, and my husband and I have two children. One is a U.S. Marine, and one is in college. They're twins. And we've lived here all of our lives, and I taught at Bullock Elementary School and Bimineau Elementary School before the Lord called us to go to Seattle, Washington. So we moved there in 2006.
You couldn't find somewhere farther away to move.
I know. 3,000 miles away. My mom can tell you exactly how many miles it is to my doorstep. But we lived there for 4 years and were able to plant a church there. And then the Lord called us back here to our hometown in Rocky Mount with our family and friends, which was awesome. And then I had some health issues, so I was unable to teach for 2 years, and I got better. And so now I am at North Carolina Wesleyan College.
And you've been in your position at Wesleyan as International Students Services Coordinator for just about a year now.
Yes, sir.
Well, tell us what that role is.
I am so blessed to be able to work with Donna Patterson. She's my Director of International Student Services at Wesleyan, and she has an amazing vision. And her vision that brought me on board with her was to help our international students become a true family at Wesleyan, for them to be able to take what they have learned from their culture and integrate it into our Wesleyan culture and our community in Rocky Mount. And that's my main goal, is to build relationships with them, to get them into our society here, and to make our campus a true family for them.
How many students, international students, do you work with?
86 from 20 different countries.
Wow. What countries are represented?
Oh, goodness. Let me see. I see my map in my head. We have everything from Nepal to Venezuela, Brazil, Cambodia, European countries, Canada. It circles the globe.
It sounds like you've got virtually every continent represented, except maybe Antarctica.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What do you focus on in terms of relationships and family connections and that sort of thing?
Okay, well, that is my main goal, to make them feel like they're part of a family at Wesleyan. Mm-hmm. And so I reach out to our community. We have lots of volunteers. We call them our go group, because they are going all the time with our students. And so they take them places. They pick them up from the airport. They provide meals for them. We have a service called Breaking Bread, where the American families host several students at a time, two or three, and they make that interaction. They serve them an American meal, get them in their homes, and make them feel a part, right, to start with. We start that as soon as they get here, and then they build relationships with them. And from there, we go into the academics part, and we make sure with our counselors at Wesleyan, they are absolutely awesome. We have two international counselors that work with them, and they help them maintain what they need academically.
Have you had any of the international students in your home?
Lots of them. Lots of them. That is one of my favorite stories. Donna and I, when I first got there, she wanted me to build relationships with them because she already knew them. So we came up with the idea to have Taste the Nations at our home. And so we had each country come and cook at my house with her husband and my husband, and we got to sample their food. And what a better way to get a feel for them and how they relate to each other than to have them cooking in our kitchen. And our number one rule was, when they walked in, English only. Uh-huh. We didn't want them talking about us behind our backs while they were cooking. So that was just awesome. And from then, I've had wonderful relationships with all of my students, and I treasure that. I just treasure that part.
It certainly, speaking of family, gives them a very intimate perspective on what an American family is like.
Yes, sir. That's what we were hoping to do, to sit down with them and pray with them before we ate and just sample their food so that we could show them that we truly care about everything that makes up their life.
Speaking of family, you've identified a song that is particularly meaningful to you in this context. Tell us about that.
Well, I love the song, We Are Family. First of all, because my family, we are so close. I have siblings, and my mom and dad are in the area as well, and my two sons and my husband, and we are very close. We do everything together. And I wanted to take that from what I have learned about what a family unit is into our international family and make Wesleyan a family for them so that they can see how we support each other. We help each other. We attend events together, whether we're involved in the events or not, just to support the other people. And I think through that, they have seen that we truly are connected. We truly are a family.
Well, let's hear the song, We Are Family by Sister Sledge. That was We Are Family by Sister Sledge. And our guest today is Dawn Turner, International Student Services Coordinator at North Carolina Wesleyan College. Dawn, you said while we were listening to that song that you have three sisters and a brother, so you can relate.
Oh, definitely. Yes, sir.
Well, Dawn, tell us a little bit more about the programs that you've put in place at Wesleyan with respect to the international students. And I have in mind, by way of example, You Before Me. What is that about?
It's a program that Donna and I have put together to allow the students to serve on Wesleyan's community as well as off-site. And it just shows them that Yes, we are so glad you're here and you have so much to offer. So we want you to take what you have to offer into our community and give back. And they do that. They are involved in the Rotaract Club and the Kiwanis Club and different things like that. They go and they speak to these organizations and tell them what they're all about, share their cultures with them, as well as serve.
What kinds of things do they share? Can you give us any examples of the sorts of things that might be unusual from the standpoint of the listener?
Well, a lot of their backgrounds. I was unfamiliar with how their schools were from their different countries. A lot of the other differences will be with how they're handled as far as relationships. Some of them have siblings who have pre-arranged marriages, places that they've traveled, that some of them have been a lot more places than some of us have in the United States, because that's what their families do. They travel, they go to school different places, and ultimately they want to end up in the United States.
Have you heard anything or seen anything in working with the students that relate to differences in terms of economic status and well-being?
Yes, sir. Several things. Right now, our Venezuelan students, you know, there's a very hard challenge in time for their families that are in Venezuela right now. So we are all praying for them and their families. But just the economic hardships that are there. Some of the other countries, they come from places where they don't have as much as we have here in America, and they don't take that for granted once they get here. They are so thankful and so humbled that they get to share that with us. And on the same standpoint, I'm humbled to be able to have them here to share that with them.
You were telling me before we came in the studio about Nepalese students who had visited you.
Oh, yes, sir. Yes, sir. The first thing they said when they came in my house was, and I have a very small house, they said, "How many families live here?" And, you know, that really just took me back to, wow.
Says something about where they came from, for sure.
Yes, in that particular area. Yes, sir.
What is Global Westfest?
Oh, I'm so excited to talk about that. We had our very first international festival at Wesleyan this year. Dr. Clark and some of our other staff and faculty there have wanted to have this for a while. And it's a Wesleyan Festival of Internationals. They performed, they sang, they danced, they wrote songs, told us a little bit about themselves. There were tables set up so that after the performances were done, the guests could go around and see their different countries that they had displayed, as well as they cooked food for us. And that was just the highlight, because we got to sample all their different kinds of food. They dressed in their cultural dress, and they were just beautiful.
You mentioned food. It is interesting, isn't it, that so much interaction and building of relationships occurs around the eating of food, around dining.
That's for sure, yes.
In fact, I understand that you've started a new program in the cafeteria related to international food.
Yes, our cafeteria, they are just wonderful as far as wanting to allow the international students' voice to be heard. So we decided to have a Taste the Nations Day about every 2 or 3 weeks in the cafeteria. And we invite our Go group, and they come and they sit down and have dinner with our international students. But the international students give all the recipes. Mm-hmm. Some of them cook the food, because some of them actually work in the cafeteria. Uh-huh. And they serve it to all of our student staff and faculty there.
That sounds terrific. What a great experience. You have identified another song for us that I think fits in pretty well here. Tell us about that.
That's What Friends Are For. I have a lot of dear friends. My husband is my very best friend, but I have a lot of girlfriends that have meant the world to me in my life. Donna Patterson is one of those, and I'm fortunate enough to be able to work with her. But they have helped mold me and shape me and given me wisdom through my life, and I'm so thankful. And I want our international students to be able to have that on campus too. So we're trying to build relationships and foster those things with American friendship with our international students. And one way to do that is by allowing them to be in clubs with the Americans so that they can support them, they can learn from the Americans, and the Americans can support the internationals and learn from them. Because it takes everybody, and they need good friendships, good solid friendships to encourage what they're going through here, because it's a lot of culture shock. They need people that can help them.
Well, let's hear the song, That's What Friends Are For, by Dionne Warwick, joined by Stevie Wonder, Elton John, and Gladys Knight.
Thank you. never thought I'd feel this way. And as far as I'm concerned, I'm glad I got the chance to say that I do believe I love you. And if I should ever go away, well then close your eyes and try to feel the way we do today. And then if you can remember, keep smiling, keep shining, knowing you can always count on me. For sure, that's what friends are for. For good times and bad times, I'll be on your side forevermore. That's what friends are for.
Well, you can't. For sure, that's what friends are for. In good times, in bad times, I'll be on your side forevermore. Oh, that's what friends are for. Oh, keep smiling, keep shining, knowing
That was Dionne Warwick and Friends singing That's What Friends Are For. Her friends in that case being Stevie Wonder, Elton John, and Gladys Knight. If you're just joining us, this is Grace Notes. I'm Alan Button, and our guest today is Dawn Turner. Dawn is the International Students Services Coordinator at North Carolina Wesleyan College. Dawn, I'm struck by one of the lines in that song that talks about for good times and bad times. That's what friends are for. Speaking of times, good and bad, there no doubt are special challenges that you have faced. What can you tell us about the challenges in your current role?
Well, I guess I would say one of the challenges I'm facing right now is just more volunteers. Mm-hmm. We have 86 students, and we need lots more volunteers that could come and get on board with us there just to support them. Yes.
What does it take to be a volunteer?
Well, we just have to get a background check and find out exactly what their interest level would be, because we have several different ways for volunteers to support us. We have 10 to 15 different ways for people to just do little bits at a time or get heavily involved.
And do you coordinate those volunteer efforts?
Yes, sir.
I imagine that can present its own set of challenges.
Yes, sir. I'm on my phone constantly.
Uh-huh. You're moving your thumbs. You do a lot of texting.
Oh, yes, sir.
What are the housing arrangements for the students?
We are blessed to have a residence hall called Nash, and that's where most of our international students stay. And a lot of them, after the first year, they decide to move off campus. So then they find apartments and 3 or 4 or 5 or 6, ever how many move in together.
You mentioned earlier Dr. Clark. I gather that's Dewey Clark, the president of the college?
Yes, sir.
And no doubt the programs that you've talked about couldn't happen without the support of the administration, and they're making that a special priority. Have I got that right?
Yes, sir. We're very blessed at North Carolina Wesleyan to have Dr. Clark in the leadership role. He has a 10-year vision plan, and right now everything is on target, and things are happening. More students are coming. North Carolina Wesleyan College's name is getting out there through everybody on campus. It's one big unit that helps everybody.
It strikes me, Dawn, that what you do as the International Student Services Coordinator is more than just a job for you. Tell us about that. What gets you excited? Why do you do what you do?
Well, it is my passion, as you can tell, from teaching to doing this, to build relationships with people, students, families, and to be able to share what I have in my heart that God has put inside of me with other people. And every day, Donna and I know we've got the best job on campus because we get to work with students every day. And we are so blessed to have the team that we have, our counselors, our advisors, everybody that works with us. We couldn't do it without them. So we rely on them. They rely on us. But it is my passion to see changes happen within these students. And I get to see it every day.
I'm interested in hearing your take on the recent immigration debates that have been going on. Has that had any impact on your program, or how does it affect how you think about things and deal with the students and look at the whole immigration situation?
Well, of course, it was a huge concern at the beginning because they were all fearful of what could happen. But I think now they're resolved to the fact to know that they are legal under an F-1 visa, so they are fine. And we've tried to communicate that to them from the beginning, that you all at Wesleyan, you are fine. We're going to take care of you. We're going to make sure that you have your status that you need to stay here and study and learn all you can so that you can take it back to your country one day and help your country. So I think now that they are more settled with that.
Speaking of taking things back to their country, what in the long term are your hopes, your aspirations for these students?
Well, we'd love to see them stay here and enrich our communities as well, but a lot of them, their goals are to go back and help their country, help their family, to do something there that's going to make a difference to enrich their lives.
It occurs to me, too, that the programs that I have some familiarity with have as a focus not only the students who are visiting, but the ones who are being visited. In other words, the ones who are here. And no doubt the presence of these international students enriches the lives of the American students on campus.
We hope so. We have several Americans that are involved with our internationals. We have a club on campus. It's called International Bishops Association that is just for that one goal, so that Americans and internationals can come together. It's for socialization, it's for service, and it's to get them to have a cultural exchange with our American students. And so by that, they build relationships with them. They share, they can tutor each other, they can communicate with each other, they can learn vocabulary that the Americans use, you know, because it's so enriching for Donna and I to see, and it makes our life just so complete when we see an international student have a conversation with an American and be able to laugh and joke, because that truly lets us know that they are fitting in, that they are communicating well when they can laugh and joke with another student.
You've identified another song for us that I think relates to the passion with which you speak. Tell us about that song.
Oh, goodness, that's Flashdance, and it's called What a Feeling. And that's the only thing I can use to describe how I feel about my job and what God has allowed me to do at Wesleyan with these students. And there's nothing greater than to be able to see your passion fulfilled every day.
Flashdance, as you know, was written by Irene Cara. And I understand she was a dancer, and the line that is sung throughout that song, what a feeling, she viewed as a metaphor about her dancing. And I gather that translates well to what you do with the students and how you live your life. In fact, the song talks about passion, too. What a feeling. I'm dancing through my life.
Yeah, that's the way I feel. It's like I'm not even working a job because I see it as a total ministry, a total service that I can do for these students to enrich them any way I can. I'm just so humbled to be able to do that. And it is my passion. And there's no greater feeling that I can think of to be able to go to work and do that every day.
This is Grace Notes, and our guest today has been Dawn Turner, International Students Services Coordinator at North Carolina Wesleyan College. Dawn, we're going to hear this song, Flashdance, but before we do, I want to thank you for being here. It's been a real treat talking with you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. It was my honor to be here. Thank you.
Let's hear it. Flashdance by Irene Cara. You've been listening to Grace Notes, a special program here on Life 103.1 featuring people who may be relatively unknown, but who meet life's challenges in ways that brighten the lives of those around them. Our producer is Christina Dolan. I'm Alan Button, and we invite you to join all of us here at the station again next Friday at 5:30 for Grace Notes on Life 103.1.